In April this year, the Ministry of Health revealed that it had stationed at least 20 ambulances on major highways across the country. The move also saw the establishment of a national ambulance service as one of the top priorities of the Ministry of Health, as embedded in the National Emergency Medical Services Policy and Strategy, the National Development Plan 3, and the NRM Manifesto of 2021-2025.
Not many Ugandans are aware of an ambulance that can be called to their area. So we see that about 19% of Ugandans say that they know of an ambulance that can be called to their location or to their village.
However, the activists say these ambulances are still of little use to the ordinary Ugandans.
And for these ambulances, the higher number mentioned that they know of the ambulance provided by the Member of Parliament. Then 8% mentioned that they know of ambulances provided by the Ministry of Health. So our question or our ask to the Ministry, how do we ensure that we have a registry that is able to document every single ambulance that is available in Uganda, so that in case of a medical emergency, it's easy to mobilize those resources and dispatch them.
Nanyanzi also points out that the use of ambulances has been a reserve for the few affluent Ugandans, while the majority who are poor prefer using traditional emergency response means, such as calling a neighbor to help them, or even just walking to the hospital.
Those in the rural areas are reporting an average of 51 minutes when they are waiting to be attended to. Then those in the urban areas are waiting an average of 29 minutes before they are attended to. So we need to have a balance. Is it an issue of the number of facilities in the urban centers that there are more, that Ugandans get attended to faster in comparison with those that are residing in the rural areas?
The same report also indicates that the health services in the country are still very poor, characterized by poor emergency response facilities, understaffed public health facilities, lack of medical supplies, among other concerns.
What is it that we need to offset to see that Ugandans are able to get a balanced experience, that when you go to a public facility, you're able to get quality services and the health workers have a positive attitude towards you, which matches that of those that are able to afford the private facilities.
Dr. Juliet Nabanja, on behalf of the Ministry of Health, agreed that the emergency medical services in the country are still wanting. However, more is being done to improve the situation.
Emergency medical transportation, this is the National Ambulance Service, and since 2020, the Ministry of Health has so far procured 250 ambulances. Some are in the country already. 100 are being awaited for by next year, and 14 boat ambulances. These are to respond to both road and water-related emergencies.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.